Hello and welcome to another episode of the Daily Roundup. I am Aditi. In this segment, we bring to you some of the most important stories that we report about here at Newsclick. The Supreme Court on Wednesday held Reliance Communications Chairman Anil Ambani and two others, Reliance Telecom Chairman Satish Seth and Reliance Infratel Chairperson Chaya Virani, guilty of contempt of court for violating its order to pay dues worth rupees 550 crore to Ericsson. Ericsson is a multinational networking and telecommunications company headquartered in Stockholm, Sweden. The three Reliance companies have been held guilty of contempt and a fine of rupees 1 crore each has been imposed on them. The Apex Court, however, has given an opportunity to the Reliance companies to purge contempt by paying rupees 453 crore to Ericsson within 4 weeks, failing which Anil Ambani will be sent to prison for 3 months. The Swedish gear maker has alleged that Reliance Group has willfully and consciously defied the order of the top court and the undertaking given before it to pay up by September end. The Apex Court on October 23 had given one last opportunity to Arcom for clearing the settlement amount by setting December 15 as the deadline, but this deadline was also missed. For our second story, we're going to take you to Pune, where over 200 farmers who were on their way to Nashik from Dhule to participate in the Farmers' Long March were taken into custody yesterday on February 19. And on February 15, leaders of the All India Kisan Sabha AIKS, including Maharashtra General Secretary Ajit Nawale, were booked for taking part in the farmers' meeting in Ahmednagar.
Kisan Sabha ka jo Long March abhi nikal raha hai, 4 baje se hum niklenge. ये लॉन्ग मार्च न हो इसके लिए बहुत बड़ा प्रयत्न सरकार की ओर से किया गया और ये लॉन्ग मार्च रुके इसके लिए बाधाएं सरकार खड़ी कर रही है। इस लॉन्ग मार्च की तैयारी के लिए अहमदनगर में एक बड़ा कन्वेंशन शेडनेट और पॉलीहाउस किसानों का बुलाया गया था। ये एक नया सेक्शन है जो किसान सभा से जुड़ रहा है और ये अत्यंत संकट में और कर्जे के तले दबे हुए किसानों का ये बहुत बड़ा मास महाराष्ट्र में है। तो किसान सभा के बैनर तले वो इस लॉन्ग मार्च में शरीक होने के लिए कॉन्फ्रेंस हमने महाराष्ट्र के अहमदनगर जिले में की। बहुत शांततामय तरीके से ये कॉन्फ्रेंस हुई। इसके बावजूद सरकार ने जो दबाव पुलिस पे डाला उसके चलते खुद मुझ पे और मेरे साथ बहुत सारे किसानों पे एक केस लॉन्च किया गया और उसके बाद फिर अलग अलग तरीके से हमें रोकने की कोशिश, हम नगर में ही रुके रहे, इस लॉन्ग मार्च तक न पहुंचे इसके लिए प्रयास 7 दिनों से लगातार चलता रहा।
The AIKS has given the call for the second Kisan Long March from Nashik to Mumbai starting today until February 27 with a number of demands including minimum support price for farm produce, complete loan waiver, irrigation related issues, proper insurance scheme for farmers, hike in pension for old farmers and food security. Earlier, in March 2018, over 50,000 farmers had participated in the first ever Kisan Long March when farmers had marched from Nashik to Mumbai in 7 days. The march concluded with the Chief Minister's promise that all demands will be fulfilled. However, the state government has failed in fulfilling even a single demand, even after more than 11 months. So, the call for the second Kisan Long March was given by the CPIM-affiliated AIKS. The first Long March had received tremendous response from all across the state. Residents of Mumbai had arranged food for the farmers who came on foot to Mumbai. They were even provided footwear after photos of their bleeding feet went viral. The farmers had even walked to the assembly at night so as not to disturb the students appearing for board examinations, a move which was applauded by the public. In international news, Maria Ressa, editor of the website Rappler, was arrested in connection with a case of libel under a draconian anti-cybercrime law. The offending article was, however, published months before the law even took effect. Authorities in the Philippines on Wednesday arrested award-winning journalist Maria on charges of libel, which carries a prison term of 12 years. Ressa is the editor of the site Rappler, which has criticized the anti-drug policies of the Rodrigo Duterte government. In the aftermath of massive international pressure and condemnation of the arrest by various human rights groups, authorities released her on bail on Thursday, for which she had to pay $1,900. On February 7, thousands of Haitians took to the streets of the capital Port-au-Prince and other main cities such as Les Cayes, Mirabalais, etc. to protest against corruption and demand the resignation of President Jovenel Moise, who led the country into a socio-political and economic crisis. Protesters in Haiti are demanding the resignation of the president, who is accused of embezzlement of $3.8 billion of Venezuela's petrocribe funds. Frustrated over increasing loss of purchasing power and misgovernance, thousands of Haitians, members of various grassroots organizations and political leaders mobilized across the country for four consecutive days to protest against widespread inflation and demand the resignation of this president. The series of mobilizations that began on February 7 completely paralyzed activities throughout the capital, Port-au-Prince, and other major cities of the country. That is all we have for you today in this episode of the Daily Roundup. To read further about these stories, click on the links in the description below. To follow many more such stories, visit our website www.newsclick.in. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook. Thank you.